Yes, this map of the Earth is upside down. We're showing it to you that way to jolt your brain into noticing something curious about our planet. The land is really unevenly distributed. More than two-thirds of it is in the More than two-thirds of the land on Earth is in the north. Welcome to Lopsided Earth. Over the years, people have come up with all sorts of hypotheses to explain this uneven distribution. Some thought that the rotation of the Earth was somehow pushing the continents upward, sort of like what happens to a smoothie in a blender. Others believed that, as the Earth cooled, it deflated into a saggy upside-down pyramid, and the oceans rushed in to fill the faces, which left land exposed on all the corners, most of which were in the north. And at least for a while, still others were sure that this uneven distribution wasn't actually true. They thought that there must be a massive but somehow hidden southern continent that balanced out all that land in the north. But they were wrong. Not just the invisible continent people, but everyone with clever theories about the northernness of the planet's land. The actual reason there's so much land in the northern hemisphere is that we're basically looking at a random screenshot from a very long, very slow, geological movie. In fact, it's just as likely that another screenshot would show most of the land in the south, or the east, or the west. That's because the Earth's land is constantly getting redistributed. The uneven heating and cooling of molten rock in the mantle creates convection currents that drag around the tectonic plates in a route that's, well, all over the map. So if you pause the Earth movie at Pangea 250 million years ago, 70% of the land would have been in the south. Around then, though, a combination of lots of extra heat bubbling up in the south and a downwelling of slightly cooler molten rock in the north started pulling most of the continental plates slowly towards the north heavy arrangement we're so familiar with. That particular arrangement may have actually been a lucky break for us as a species, since the interaction of tectonic plates created the unique features of the Great Rift Valley where humans first evolved. Perhaps we wouldn't even exist to ponder this lopsidedness if the continents never took their current shape. But this configuration won't last. The movie will go on. One recent model projects that, over the next 200 million years or so, the continental plates will once again smush together to form a supercontinent. This time one that's shaped sort of like an overweight chicken, and is roughly half above and half below the equator. At least for the moment.